Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna have, I don't call it my favorites. What I call it is products that are rocking my world right now. And I don't usually do a lot of favorites. I just do these occasionally because I don't buy a lot of stuff. Because, you know, I have a broke bitch budget. So just whenever I do have stuff, you know, that stands out to me or just recently got stuff, I'll talk about it, or, you know, something in my Ipsy or Birchbox that I really like, I'll talk about that too. So let's go ahead and get started, and I got some food on here, and some, a drink too that I wanted to talk about. I want to try to go through this super fast, so let's go ahead and get started. Start with what we start with, primer, and I've talked about this in my recently hauled Hard and Horrible, and both these primers for Elf, from Elf, this is just the regular one. I had the box, I think I threw it away. It's just, really has no scent to it. I mean, it has a slight one, but you really can't notice it. It's white, but it goes on. It just smooths your skin, and it makes your foundation go on so effortlessly, and it makes it last all day long. The Aqua Primer Mist, I love using, either of these work fine by themselves, but I use them both together. I put this one on first, and then this one. This hydrates my skin super, super well. And I really love it for that. I'm almost out of this. That's how much I love it. You can use it as a setting spray. The only thing I don't like is the sprayer on here jets out. And if you use it as a setting spray, it'll mess your makeup up. So you have to put it in another bottle. But other than that, both of these make my makeup last all day long. And I absolutely love both of them. And I'm so glad I got them. I now have two favorite primers. Because I was trying all different ones. But those two from Elf are spot on. Now, foundation-wise, I got the CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous in 105. It's a little bit too dark for me. It's actually good now because I've got a little sun the past couple of weeks doing yard work and stuff. Love this. It lasts about 7-8 hours on my skin. It just looks beautiful on my skin. It blends nicely. It works with either a brush or a beauty blender type sponge. And like I said, it lasts 7-8 hours. My skin looks really nice with this. And when it breaks down, it usually starts around here and it doesn't break down ugly or anything like that. It's just a little bit you can tell. But I really, really like it. I can see why people like this, and I know I'm late on the boat on it, and I'm putting them back where they belong. This is my favorite one right here, the CoverGirl True Blend, and this is the one in Ivory, L1. Absolutely love this. Lasts about 10 hours. This is what I got on today, mixed with my NYX Gleam Illuminator to give it a little bit more color, and my Tarte Maracuja Oil, which you know I always do. I'm like down to here already, and I've only had it for about a month. Love this. This my skin looks so pretty with this on. It reminds me of the Maybelline Better Skin Super Stay, how it looks on my skin. The color match is perfect. I love it. My skin looks so great with this on. I don't know what it is about it, and it lasts nicely. Really, it breaks down. It's very minimal. I mean, it's holy grail status for me, and I never would have thought to get it. It was on sale because it's been out for a few years, but I decided to get it because it was on sale, and I'm absolutely in love with it, and I would buy it again, just like I would the Maybelline Superstay Better Skin. I'd definitely buy it again. Okay, and let's open this up. This eyeshadow come in my Ipsy bag. It's from INT Cosmetics, and yes, this is my Ratchet palette that I glue my stuff in. This is in Goddess Gold. It is just so super soft. It can be used as an eyeshadow or a highlighter if you got a little bit darker skin than I do. It's buttery. It lasts on my eyes all day with or without a primer. I have been wearing it out. I've got a dip in it already over here on this side. I have been wearing this non-stop. I mean, non-stop pretty much. I don't have it on today because I did a really bright eye today. I'll show you what I have on. It's just so super smooth. It reminds me of O4 Cosmetics powders. And the packaging kind of looked like that too, so it may be made by the same company, I don't know. But I think it's a little bit less expensive than Ofra. But if y'all got this, give it a try. It is really, really pretty. And Ofra also, or these three are Ofra right here, but these two highlighters right here, this is the one in New Glow Girl, the pink one, and the UDU is the more peachy one, which is what I have on as my highlighter today. See? You can see it for miles. Marvin the Martian can see it. Massive dents in these. These are the highlighters I've been wearing mostly this month for some reason. I've been wearing them on my eyes too. Really, just for some reason I've been gravitating towards these. And these are some of my only high-end highlighters. But they're so buttery soft. They blend in my skin so beautifully. And they just beam to, you know, know, Marvin the Martian, but you can also put them on lightly to where they're not this beaming on you. And I just love them. If you've never tried an Ophir powder, give it a try. They are really, really good, guys. Really good. And my couple of favorite blushes is my Maybelline Master Blush by Face Studio. All three of these are gorgeous. I have this mixed with my other blush today. And then the highlighter, I showed this in my highlighter video. It is super pretty too. Just all three of these are gorgeous, but this is my favorite one. This is why I bought it, the plum one. I just thought it was so super pretty. And I'm sorry if you hear banging or anything in the background. We got all our windows open today because it is super, super nice outside and cool. So we got all our windows open today. So I'm sorry if you hear anything in the background. And y'all know I love my LA Colors. I love Makeup Contour Kit. I've got dents in pretty much all these right here. This is the contour shade. I got that on today. And along with the bronzers, got those on today. And I'm sorry my hair looks horrible, guys. I know I've had it up a lot. I need to get it cut because it got a lot of dead ends and it's just not looking right. Excuses, excuses, I know. But I'm broken. I have to cut it myself and I haven't felt like cutting it. But I just... This is the perfect contour shade for me. I know you can probably barely see it, but it works perfectly for me. I have it on my nose and under here. And I mix these two bronzers down here, and this is what I have on now. And this powder here, big dent in this one. I use this one to set my eyeshadow primer sometimes, and I'll use it underneath here to set my concealer too, and it does not go into my fine lines. This was only $6. Absolutely adore this. If you're broke like I am, give it a try. The powders, it's not overly powdery. It doesn't settle on my fine lines, and it blends out nicely, and that's really the main things you're looking for. And the other blush that I'm loving is the Wet n Wild Color Icon in Pearlescent Pink. I've also got this mixed with the other one by Maybelline. This is my favorite color icon by Wet n Wild blush. It's perfect for the spring and summer and lasts all day on my cheeks, and it's buildable. You have to really build this. I will say that it's not overly pigmented like some of the other ones I have. You have to build this, but once you build it, it lasts, and it's gorgeous. It goes with all different kinds of eye looks and, you know, colors and everything. I'm just in love with it. Okay, what next? What next? Okay, Super Late on the Boat, Maybelline Instant Age Rewind, the Dark Circle Eraser, the light one. Love this. If my dark circles aren't too bad, this works perfectly. I don't have to use the salmon colored one. They aren't too bad. You can see how much I've already used. Doesn't settle into my fine lines. Blends out beautifully. I even use it as a primer for my eyeshadow sometimes. I didn't do it today. I used something else. Love this. So glad I finally tried it. I know. Super late on the boat on that one. Now something else I use to set my eyeshadow and primer or concealer, and it's what I've been using a lot, and I talked about it in my highlighter video, but it's an eyeshadow, and this is old school. I use this in high school a lot, you know, and I've got it up here today too. Absolutely love this. This is the French Vanilla CoverGirl eyeshadow single. You can see I've hit pan right there probably. There is just something about this. I mean, it's a big old dip in a pan. It sets my eyeshadow nicely, and you can use it as a really light highlighter. It just gives off a slight sheen to it. And it's just beautiful, and it sets my, you know, primer or my concealer perfectly, and that's what I've been using to set it with. Okay, let's go on to this that I got in my Ipsy, I think. It's the Ciate Bamboo Bronzer. Looks like that on the outside. Come on, open. It had a little bow indention here. I've been using this so much that that's gone. And what I use it for, yeah, it's a bronzer. I used it for a bronzer one, you know, a couple of times, but I use it to contour my nose. But what I mainly use it for is in my crease. Almost every day I use this in my crease, and it is the perfect color for my crease. It blends beautifully all over the face and my nose. Absolutely love it. I put it underneath my lip to make my bottom lip look fuller. Blends beautifully, lasts all day. Highly recommend it. If you got it, give it a try, guys. The e.l.f. Pearls, the natural. I've already talked about these before, how people say they're not pigmented enough when they're not supposed to be. You get a puff with them, but I use a brush with mine, and you know, there's pink, yellow, white, and brown, and darker brown in there. I just put my brush in there and basically do it all over my face, and what I call it is the finishing powder, and it just gives me a little bit extra glow, like, you know, Wet n Wild Reserve, your cabana. A lot of people like using that all over their face because it gives them that liquid ferment glow all over their face, and they love that. This does the same thing, guys. And what I do is I call it my finishing powder, not a setting powder, but a finishing powder. Do not use it underneath your eyes. It's got too much of a glow if you do that. But as a finishing powder, it just sets my makeup all day. I have normal to dry skin for reference. Sets my makeup all day. Love it. Love it. Love it. It was like $10. And that'll probably last me forever because those pearl things last forever. Let's move on. Let's do the eyebrow. The e.l.f. Eyeliner and Eyebrow. And this is the one. What is this, Anita? Medium brown. Oh, I gotta lean back, guys. My back's hurting me. Love this. This is what I got on now. Y'all know the e.l.f. Brow Pencil and Taupe is my holy grail. But I decided to get this when I ran out. Looks like that. This is the perfect color for me. It's what I got on now. I can put this on, like, at half the time I can put the pencil on. I just get my e.l.f. Angled eyebrow brush. Half the time, my brows are done. I do not like spending a ton of time on my eyebrows. I know a lot of people do, but I like the more natural look, and I, you know, something that can make it more quick and easy for me. Definitely. I have not used it for the eyeliner. I got it specifically for my eyebrows. I probably will never try it as an eyeliner, but that's what I specifically got it for. And sounds like my cats are out there having a party with whatever they're finding. Sorry if you hear noises. Okay, next up is mascara. This is the Maybelline Colossal Big Shot. You know, Makeup by Shayla, Manny MUA did the ad. I did not buy it because of them. And, you know, a lot of the bigger YouTubers really like this. But I've watched a lot of smaller YouTubers that I watch really, really like this. This is what I got on today. I don't have any false lashes on, but this is what the mascara I got on today, and that's the curl I get. I curled my lashes like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Put this on. Love it. For some reason, it lasts on me. Everybody knows. I keep seeing somebody walk back and forth. They're probably looking at me like, what is she doing talking to a camera? But it is more of a wet former, and you do kind of need to wipe your brush off a little bit. That's what it looks like. Just regular bristles. Mascara is subjective to everybody. It's one of the most subjective things. Like, y'all know one of my least favorite products in the world is the Jordana Better Lash, or whatever it's called. Hate it, and it didn't work on me. Everybody loves that stuff. I can't stand it. It did nothing but clump my lashes. This is clumping people's lashes, but the only time it clumps mine is if I don't clean off the brush, and if I do more than 3 coats. I do usually just 2 coats, and this is what I get. So, and I love it. You know, I don't care who did the ad. I love it. Forgot to grab one thing. Crap. Oh, I got this. I think it was in my Birchbox. The Benefit They're Real. I see why people love this. It's got the rubber bristle brush. And it's got the spiky torture device on the end, which is pretty good for doing your lower. This is what I got on my lower today. This is really good. It does not curl my lashes as good as, you know, the Maybelline does. But it does curl them decently enough. I prefer it on the lower. And my hair is driving me nuts. I'm sorry. It looks horrible, guys. What I really love about this, it does hold a curl. The Maybelline, you know, it's just as good as the Maybelline at holding a curl. Lasts a decent amount of time. The only thing I don't like about it is I almost always put on 2 coats of mascara. And it just makes my lashes feel kind of crunchy. Like right now, they don't really feel crunchy with the Maybelline one on. But with these, if I do 2 coats, they feel super crunchy. They don't look bad. They just feel crunchy. And this is so hard for me to get off for some reason. It's not waterproof. It's really hard for me to get off, and I don't know why. But I love it. And they don't smudge, and they don't flake. Neither one of them smudge or flake on me. And I love them for that. Okay, what's up next? Let's do some brushes. Y'all know it took me forever to find the Wet n Wild Crease Brush. I'm sorry it's dirty. I used it today. I mean, Nikki Tutorials loves this. A lot of big ones really love this. It's not too dense, not too soft. And I use it more to put a little bit deeper color to deepen my crease up. Really, really love it. It was only like 99 cents at Kroger. And another one, these two I got in my Ipsy bag. This is the Skone Cosmetics Blending Brush. It is super, super dense. Not dense, but soft. Super soft. I use this to put down the bamboo bronzer color in my crease because it's super soft. It lays it down softly and lightly. And then you can build it up. And I have another one. And I use keep it clean, and I use it to blend out everything. It just makes everything look airbrushed. The other one that I got, y'all know I love my Luxie brushes, because every time I get a Luxie brush in my Ipsy bag, I freaking love them. I mean, if I could do backflips, I would, because I love every Luxie brush I've got. I have loved. They are amazing. This is the 514 blush brush. I do not use it for blush. I used it today. Sorry, I use it for bronzer. Got dust going everywhere. This is what I use for bronzer because it's not super dense. It's small enough and it fits my needs of the way I like to wear my bronzer. Let's put it that way. And I got a couple of these and I absolutely adore them. They're soft, super, super soft. That's one thing about Luxie brushes. They're super soft and it just blends everything beautifully and makes it look airbrushed. I mean, and I'll use it. Also, I'll use the other one with this one to set my face, and I like using it for that. Okay, what is next? Let's move on to lips. I'm gonna lean out of frame real fast. I'm sorry, I'm doing this to y'all again, but I wanted to show y'all something else. I'm really bad about forgetting stuff. I'm sorry, guys. This is my new obsession. Sorry, and I'm telling around again. It's not a Nita video unless I knock y'all around and drop shit and everything else. God. This is, like I said, my new obsession, the Wet n Wild Gel Lip Liner, and this is the one in 6.5 and 7.8 Plum Together. Gel Lip Liner, which means it's going to glide on super effortlessly and smooth. And I got the darker one because I needed it to go with, let my darker lip colors like this. Guys, with it being a gel, it moisturized my lips, and I will wear this by itself with the Wet n Wild Pout and Love Gel Lip Balm, and this is in 955B and Love. There's a little bit of color payoff to it. You can kind of see the pink. I will put this on, and then I'll put this over it to give it more of a shine, and it lasts. I'll just touch up throughout the day with this, and it just lasts, most of my day, like 7 to 8 hours. And I'll bring this with me too in case I need to touch it up. I want all of them. They're only like $2.99, and I've heard other people like Jam Beauty Jessica, what was her last name? But Jam Beauty 89, she loves the, I think it's Jessica Brown. She loves these too because I think she got sent all of them. They are just amazing. They're only $2.99, and the lip balm, they have other colors of it too. Pair these together, they look great together. But I got it mainly so it would go with my darker lip colors, like this one. It goes with that. And I got a NYX one that I got, a real dark NYX one that I got in an Ipsy bag. It goes great. Let's go. This is what I've got on today. And this is a lip combo that I have been wearing pretty much nonstop. This is the LA Colors Matte. And I think this is called Natural or Neutral. This comes in the I Love Makeup LA Colors Cup I got. It didn't have a name on it. This is what I have on, with this on top of it, and this is the e.l.f. Pout Perfector in Glow, and it gives you that metallic look. I'm going to rant for a minute here, because I've got a couple of things in here that, are good toppers. The e.l.f. Glitter Gloss, and this is the one in Golden Glitz. My rant is, companies think we're stupid. The new thing is lip toppers, and all the companies are doing, Kevin Aucoin, Smashbox, L'Oreal, not L'Oreal, Lancome, all the companies are doing these. Every company out there is doing these right now, pretty much. Guys, they're lip gloss. They're fucking lip gloss. Excuse my damn language. They're lip gloss. And people say, well, lip gloss is sticky. No, it's not. Neither one of these are sticky. I have plenty of lip glosses. These here. This has glitter in it. This is the LA Color Shea Butter. These are not sticky. None of these are sticky. I have plenty of lip glosses over here that aren't sticky, because I don't like sticky lip glosses, even though y'all know I am a lip gloss connoisseur. I love lip gloss. Those aren't sticky. I don't like sticky lip glosses. If they're sticky, I really don't wear them. I can handle a level of sticky, but if they're sticky, I really don't like to wear them. So most of mine are not sticky. My lips are not sticky right now. This is not sticky. This is not sticky. Their lip toppers are lip gloss. All they're doing is calling it something else so they can get your hard-earned money. If you don't mind blowing your money, go ahead. Go right ahead. But if you're poor like I am, no. No, no, you're not suckering me in. I don't care if you're drugstore or not. And plenty of them look like this. This has been out forever. I don't know if it's still out, but I'm pretty sure they still got something like this. This one here, this is more metallic one. This is the one I got over it right now. Look at that. Lip toppers are lip gloss. Okay? I'm not stupid. I'm not going to buy into it. I'm done. And I showed you the two shea butter from LA Colors, and I've been wearing these two a lot. That's why I got them out, too. And also to say, these are some lip glosses that aren't sticky. The Playful one, y'all know this is one of my favorites. I've been wearing this one a lot. love the paddle brush. Look at that. And it's got glitter in it. Goes great over just, you know, a neutral lip color. And this is the one in Snuggle. This is my other favorite. I put this over a lot over MAC's Velvet Teddy, which I've been wearing that a lot lately, too. What did I put you? Right there. Look at that. And these are lip glosses, and they're so opaque. Y'all know I love these things, and they're only $2. And finally found, you know, they finally come out, LA Colors finally come out with more of their matte liquid lip colors. This is the one in Danger. Love it. This is the one in Fierce. Love it. But this one, for some reason, is my favorite. And it's more of a fall color, but I have been wearing it. It's an Illusion. These last on my lips forever. They don't flake off, you know, go into my lines or anything. And I love them. They're only $2 or $2.50. This is a real, in there, this one, yeah, this one I only had to put one layer on, really. Look at that. Such a dark red color, almost. I just love it. $2, guys. This is like an LA Colors love fest. Telling you, they got some good stuff. Love those. And here are some two other things that I got in my, I think it was Birchbox. They sent me this one first. This is the PBJ Smoothie Stick, and this is the one. Now, I saw a name on this one, but there's not one on this one. These, my dang hair, these are super creamy. They glide on. They last, you know, the same amount of time as any lip crayon does. They're super pretty. I really like them. They are pretty moisturizing. This is the second one that they sent me, and this is in Saucy. It's a more darker color, but I have been wearing this, and I'll put this over it. It looks really pretty together. I'll also put the other one over it too, and they look really pretty together. But like I said, this month my main combo has been these two. This is what I got on today, and I absolutely love that combo. Okay, let's get all this out of the way. I am so sorry I went off like that about the lip toppers, but guys, to me, it's just for the way for them to call, you know, name something. Something else to get your money. That's all it is. Point blank. Okay, one thing I wanted to share. Y'all know I got this. Okay, here. Earlier this year or late last year, and I bought them out because they said it was a seasonal collection. And it's the Winter Frost by Dahl. They're 98 cents at Walmart. They got them still. I found them the other day, and my husband got me some. Love these. They remind me of cool water cologne. So, if I know somebody commented that they wanted to try it, go and look at Walmart. They still got them. Now, the food and everything I wanted to share with you. Sorry, I'm drinking this right now, and I do need a drink. Oh, my God, it's so good. This is aloe vera drink, mango flavor. This is really, it's pretty much all natural. I know you're like, aloe vera, ooh. All you taste is the mango. It's so good for you. It's super refreshing. I mean, I really love it. I mean, I got strong there. I'm sorry. But you get it at Kroger, and I know Kroger on the West Coast is Ralph's. So if you have a Ralph's, get it there. But if you got Kroger, they're only $1 a piece. Really, really like them. And I think they put them on sale sometimes for a little bit cheaper, but really, really like them. And y'all know now that I got the hypoglycemia, I have to eat better and more, so I'm trying to eat better too. I picked up these, what is it called? Del Duca on the go, Dusha on the go, Smart Snacker, prosciutto bites, provolone cheese, and breadsticks. And it's got no nitrates, no MSGs. They look like this. They're like $2 and something. And it's got prosciutto and cheese here. It's got some breadsticks. Love these guys. I eat the heck out of them. I mean, when my blood sugar's low, I eat this and I feel much better. They're just a few. And prosciutto's like an Italian ham, kind of. Really, really, really good. If you need something quick and it's satisfying, but it's quick and it's good for you. I really, really like them. And I am been eating hummus like it's going out of style, and I've been eating this one non-stop. It's the Pita Pal hummus variety pack. It has original spicy jalapeno, roasted red pepper, and olive. The spicy jalapeno, you notice it's not touched because my husband eats that one. But before then, he would not eat hummus because he's like, that sounds, it's too healthy, because I eat a lot of healthy food, not driving nuts, but he would not eat it. And I'm like, would you just try this, the jalapeno one, for me? He's like, oh, that's good. It kind of reminds me of bean dip. I was like, it's because it's made for beans. It's made from chickpeas. It's like bean dip, doofus. If you've never tried hummus, just get the flavored ones. And you know, they got flavored in like roasted red pepper, olive. I feel like olives is really good. Give them a try. This is only like four something. I get it at a grocery store here, but I think they got it at other, you know, grocery stores besides the one I get it at. Really have been eating the heck out of hummus. Okay, let me show you what's on my eyes real quick. The eyeliner I'm using, I got this in my Ipsy a while back, or maybe in my Birchbox. It's the Ico London Liquid Eyeliner in black. Looks like this. That's what the tip looks like. It's a felt tip, and that's the eyeliner I got on. It's pretty good. This is the second time I've worn it. It doesn't smear or anything, but I do have to. It's kind of hard to get close to the lash line because this is a little bit thicker of a felt tip to it. So, but on my eyes today, I pulled out my. You know, I wait for this time of year. But I love this time of year because I get to pull out my bright colors, and that's until I got the bright going on, match my shirt and everything. I pulled out my Wet n Wild California Roll and my Wet n Wild Temporary Solutions. Love these. And from this one, I got on these two in my crease. Yeah, just these two in my crease from this one. And from this one, I got on. I laid this one down first, this matte green down first, and then I laid down this more shimmery green here, which is just, oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. Love it. Look at that. I just love this palette. So when I get to pull it out and start, oh, when I got, I also got this teal color down here on my lower lash line. So when I get to pull this out and play with it, I get so excited. I love bright colors on this. But that is my products that have been rocking my world lately, and my small rant, sorry about that. Let me know down below what your favorites are. If anything in here that you've tried that you really like or don't like, I mean, just let me know. Any questions, you can put them down below. Comments, put them down below. Email me. I got more videos I need to do. I've got a tag, a couple tags I want to do. But I think that's all I wanted to talk about. I'm sorry for all the noise and me leaning on a frame and hitting the table, and it's just not a needed video without that. That's becoming my standard, isn't it? But thank y'all for everything. I love y'all for everything.